Hi Prakhar, how are you doing? I hope you have been doing very well, and I have been talking to you in the past couple of weeks. You know, this time of the year has been bad due to pandemic, but I see the light beyond the tunnel as the hotels are opening up, and you have led in your career with Sterling Resorts as AVP revenue. And since last 1.5 year, you have been managing Marriott Hotels as revenue leader. So let's start having the discussion around how do you see the hoteliers should be managing the profitability or looking at the revenue and the cost simultaneously so that you should manage the bottom line more effectively.
Good morning from India, Alak. Thank you so much, first of all, for inviting me. If I talk about the current industry state, we were severely hit. This industry, especially the airlines and hospitality, has gone significant hit in terms of the revenues which is coming in. But the positive sign is hotels have started opening now. The reopenings activities has already been done. The care to commitment activities have already been taken place. The property measurements have been done. The precautions measurement have been done now. So we are ready to welcome back this industry now. So coming back to your question, the cost effectiveness, what we are looking at from the angle of the ownership, the stakeholders, there have been some cost contingency measures which properties have been taking now to a shorter level, and we are very optimistic that industry will bounce back slowly and gradually.
This is a very good narration in terms of how you see it from a hotel standpoint. But on the same token, as you see it, the revenue has really hit the bottom, meaning so very, very low, in fact, to zero level most of the time. And most of the hoteliers are getting out of the business. So how do you see that the technology should be able to help them in terms of, first of all, generating the revenue? Because the travelers or guests are not checking in the hotel. And the second of all, how should you also manage the overheads? Because unless you're careful with the overheads, you should not be able to impact the GOP, right? So can you share some of your thoughts around how the technology can help in that area?
Yes, Alak, for sure. So what is today, what we are seeing in terms of the scenario, yes, industry has got the hit. And we have been now across into the budgeting exercise for 2021. That is being taking place for next couple of months. That's the activity which goes in. So the thought process of what we are taking is one, the growth, the ramp up or a growth from 2020 and the recovery plan, the recovery of 2019. So maybe 70 to 80% recovery is expected to be done in 2021, right, of 2019. That's the initial step across South Asia we are taking it out there. That's the industry trend which is being looked in. So the role of technology, Alak, will be the key. The role of revenue management is going to be the key here. How the slowly the business will bounce back. If you see today, the renegotiation of every account has been happening from the buyer's perspective and from the seller's perspective also. Mm-hmm. So buyers are negotiating with hospitality industry to get the better outcome, obviously, in a shorter stage. Mm-hmm. How revenue management can hold this until how long it can be held? So that the industry, when the industry will bounce back, especially in 2022, you do not need to work hard from the scratch to regain your brand in the market. So market will bounce back for sure, slowly and gradually. So revenue management will be the key. Who will guide who will take you forward to retain your pricing and lead from there. It is the game of demand and supply altogether, right? So to do that, you will definitely need to have technology in place. Your systems should speak, your data should speak. As we see the data of couple of market like China, leisure is recovering fast. Yeah, leisure segment is trending in occupancy of 55% to 60%, where the business occupancy has gone to around 20%, 25% to 30% today. So leisure has a first mover advantage today. Similarly, tier two city is moving rapidly. Yeah, tier one city may take some more time to recover. So all these analytics put together to reach to some conclusion, how will you do your segmentation of your pricing, your segmentation of your clients, the source market, business analytics, all these activities will help you to regain your 2021 and 2022. These will be the crucial year for the stakeholders of business. And in terms of the cost management, hotels have been effectively managing their cost due to heavy cost contingency measures. Maybe this will also get some leverage when the top line will start coming in slowly, right?
I mean, talking about, as you mentioned, that 2021 and 2022, that will be the years when hotel will be coming to the back in the business. And you also mentioned that the data would be the key for segmenting the business, or you shared some example like in China, lasers, our business is really coming in the top of the line, and then you can classify and segment it. So you know, Prakhar, that Centric is focused on AI, artificial intelligence driven or data driven intelligence. It is also helping in automating some processes to reduce the cost of operation, and also, you know, trying to help the employees, which can serve the hotels much better. How do you see that you should be able to allocate the area of revenue generation? So you did talk about some time ago, there are 9 segments of revenue which you focus on. Then you mentioned that, okay, if few segments are picking up, then you should allocate the cost accordingly, and then you should be able to optimize profitability. So if you can really highlight, you just touched upon lesser activity, but let's say for global marketplace, which are the segment where you see the focus areas?
Yeah, so what it will be the focus point of the events and the activities which could not take place in 2020, year 2020. There has been international events which happens every year or every 2 years in India. Indian Premier League is one, IFA Awards is one, international championships happens, that the sports events happens out there. Those events could not happen in 2020, and we do not know how soon, how long it will go in as of now. But yes, once these boundaries will open, international boundaries will open, the hotels will cater to these businesses for sure. There will be the boom in the industry for these kind of smaller and bigger events out here. Currently, the MICE is stopped completely. The MICE event meeting incentives events are not currently happening in industry. So those will take place. Pharma currently is any which way is moving. FMCG is doing well as a industry sector. So these industries are directly linked with hospitality industry in terms of the business contribution out there. The airlines, once the business will move in, airlines will come in, or airlines also does a direct support to the hotels industry business. So these demand cycle will go in future for 2021 and year 2022.
Excellent. Prakhar, since you are currently with Marriott Hotel and you know the contactless check-in due to COVID, a lot of guidelines are coming. How are you ensuring guests in terms of safety, health concerns, and all of that, and so that the guests should have the confidence. Once the guests develop the confidence, they will start traveling, they will start checking in the hotel and coming back to normal. It will take some time, but obviously you like to ensure that guests are taken care of by you. So what are the measures and how technology can help in there? If you can also highlight so that guests should be ensured that they are taken care of with the help of some technologies.
Yes, Alak. So Marriott as a brand, like other brands, has the commitment to clean initiative, which is being implemented across the properties out there. Every property has the hygiene head who ensure that the commitment to clean is being taken care of. A couple of contactless points you had mentioned. It is just not that. It is beyond that tons of data line and checklist have been given, and it is being measured by Marriott International across to ensure that guests gets the exceptional service and the limited touch points. Alak.
Okay, excellent. So for the limited, let's say, touch points, do you see that, the chatbot technology, the robotic process automation technology, which helps the guest to communicate and interact on their smartphone, not interfacing with the hotel or any property, interfaces, right? So that may ensure to have contactless checking, contactless fulfillment, contactless, execution and services, what you render, with a very, very ease of delivery. So as you know, Centric has built and offered to the hoteliers a very, very powerful system, which is called Intelligent Process Automation based chatbot technology, which is available for guests to use that. And when guests come in, they can have contactless check-in, they can order anything from the room. So those are the things, obviously, that can help and mitigate the risk which guests envisage. Now, coming back to the final point, Prakhar, I would like you to give messages to the hoteliers. What do you see from revenue standpoint, profitability standpoint, so that they should plan and execute as hotels are opening up now?
See, message for to the revenue management folks across the South Asia level is very simple. Do not get panicked. Hold yourself. Things will be reviving. Things have started reviving. If you panic, you will lose out in the market. Mm-hmm. See how the market is trending up. Mm-hmm. Yeah, demand slowly picking up. So just follow the demand naturally. Do best in terms of your content, in terms of your commitments at the property level, at the market levels. If you lose out, you need to be ahead of your competition. You should get that early advantage, early movers advantage as a brand. Take help of the brand. Go with the flow. Slowly, industry is going to bounce back. If you lose out much, your property, you will take more time to recover. Yep. So that's the very simple message I would like to convey to the revenue folks.
Very good thoughts, Prakhar, as you mentioned, that stay focused, stay positive, be alert with the trend and stay competitive as others are really looking at the market trends, and be ahead of the curve. So thank you. Your time, Prakhar. I really appreciate talking to you.
Thank you, Alak. Thank you for inviting me.